Save all the cap shit for later. I don't wanna hear it. I'm in love with a bag.
Yo, what is up guys, welcome back to another video. In today's video I'm gonna be showing you how to make that insane magic circle effect in Premiere Pro. Yeah, enjoy the video. So before I show you how to make this effect, there are things that you want to know. So make sure that when you are selecting the clip, make sure the clip is pretty clean. So what I mean by that, when you're like in the killing part, make sure the clip does not have any rapid movements. If it have any rapid movements, this effect does not gonna work properly. So make sure to select a clean clip like this, so it's like comes on and like it's pretty much a kill the effect, like no rapid movements on the clip. So make sure to select a clip just like this, and then we can apply the effect. So first, all you want to do is you just want to find the frame where you pull out the shotgun. So it's frame right here, as you can see right here. So after you find the frame where you pull out the shotgun, you're gonna cut it. And after you've done that, I'm just gonna apply my velocity. So I will be linked this texture settings in the description. So I'm just gonna apply that preset right here. Then obviously you will be need to change some settings. So first I'm just gonna adjust these keyframes. So I'm gonna go for like 7 frames like that, and I'm just gonna make like move these keyframes right here. And then I'm gonna go to this keyframe and I'm gonna change the speed to like 25-ish, yeah. And then I'm gonna go somewhere right here, so the like the shotgun is like it's up, if that makes sense. Just find a frame like this, and I'm gonna change this to 15, and again go to the other keyframe, again make it 15, and then it should be synced. So let's just play this. So it is pretty laggy, and also I'm just gonna delete the audio. Okay, I think it is synced now. And then all you wanna do is you wanna nest that thing after you apply your velocity, and then you wanna find the frame where you get the kill. So it's right here, you wanna cut it from that frame. If this clip is pretty short, you can right click on show clip keyframes, time mapping, and enable speed on the clip. In that way you can make this clip a little bit longer. So I'm gonna go like somewhere right here, and I'm gonna keyframe the speed, and I'm just gonna decrease the speed to like 30, so it'll make the, you know, like this pretty long, like this part of the clip pretty long, so we can apply the impact pretty easily. But yeah, so after you finish the clip, now we can actually apply the effects. So first you just wanna download the overlay, and you wanna put it on top of your, you know, like the clips, and you can delete the audio, and you can cut it right here. You can delete the other part, and then simply finish the clip, and then all you wanna do is change the blend mode of that to screen. Then you wanna go to your effects, and you wanna search up as transform. And you're gonna put the transform effect to the you know, like the overlay thing. And then also you can open up my preset, it's called the magic circle, just set up as like that, and put the before nest to this bottom clip, and then you will get effect just like this. Then you just wanna select the like the overlay thing, and then I'm gonna change the scale to around 70, and then you can change this value to around 2, and you can change the position like this, so it is on top of the, you know, like the character thing. And then also make sure like select the overlay, click Control D, so it'll add like fade in and fade out effects. So then you wanna go to the like where this layer starts, and you're gonna go 5 10 15, and you're gonna reduce this like the fade in within 15 frames, and also fade out this overlay in 5 frames, just like so. And then we can keyframe the position just like that, and we can, you know, change the position just a bit, just like so. And now I think it is pretty good. So yeah, After you've done that, just want to select these two clips, you know, right click and you know next the clip, and then you want to again open up my preset and you want to drag and drop the put on everything onto this part. And after you put that preset, you will get an effect something like this. So this is pretty laggy, but don't worry, after you render the clip this will look pretty good. So just play it to see how that looks. Okay, perfect. And then we can obviously apply our impact, so I'm just gonna drag it right here. And also guys, make sure after you apply that time remapping, make sure to nest the clip and then you can actually apply the impact. So yeah, now you are pretty much done. Then you can put the sound effects and then you can sync your song and you know, and do all that fancy stuff. And after that you'll be good to go. I'm gonna put it right here and I'm gonna copy my sound effect and I'm gonna paste it right here and sync it like that. And then you'll get effect like this. And before you actually preview this, go right here, click I, go to the end, click O, click on sequence, click on render into out, and then you can play this effect smoothly. So for now, let's just play this. So actually this is not actually rendered out, so that is why this is laggy. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the video, and thank you so much for watching this video. And if you learned something new or if you want more tutorials, be sure to like and subscribe the channel. So and I will catch you guys on my next video, and peace.